Hello guys, welcome back to this course. In the last video we did all these things. Here you can see we have put this logo and we have created all these menus here. So today we will continue this video and we will align these all menus. So let's start. Come to editor. Here we have our UL and li. So let's go to CSS and type here nav class. And let's design it. And here, write display flex padding 2%, 6%, 6%, and justify content. Space between. Space between aligns items center. Control S, let's see browser. You can see now these are in the top and the right side. Come to back CSS file. Let's write one more time nav. Inside nav we have image and the width will be 150 pixel. Then write nav link display flex 1 text aligns center. Instead of center, write it right. Now after this type nav link ul li list style none. Display inline block padding 8 pixels. Now go to browser and refresh it. Control S. Come back here. And sorry, we have forgotten one thing. Just type here dot before this and for here because it's a class. Control S, let's go to browser. You can see now the all the menus in the aligns horizontally, as you can see here. So now come to back on the HTML file. Now what we have to do next, we have to style this a tag, this one. You can see here, this is the color. We have to change this color also. So now come to CSS again. And here just copy it, this class. Copy, come here and I paste it here and write A. Color will be SFFA white and text decoration none. And font size will be 15 pixel. Control S, let's see it in browser. You can see now we have all these menus here, but this font is not looking good. So for that we have to change the font size. So for that, let's go to Google and type here Google fonts. Okay, and then click here Google fonts, then so for that we will use this one all our roboto, click on it, and then select your style. I will select this one first. Select this style, then regular, and then bold, this one, and then you can use light 3, this one also. Now I have selected all these here, you can see here. Now you can see this link, this one, sorry, this one, this link, this link. So what we have to do, we have to copy this, copy and come to your HTML file here, and below this link style sheet we have to paste it. Now we have to apply this font in our CSS file also. So come back to here and then copy this font family, copy, come to CSS file, and above here just paste it here, Control S, and come to browser and check it. You can see now the font style has been changed, you can see here. So next we have to apply hover effect. I mean, when we click on it, when we take our mouse on these menus, so it should be hover something. So for that, let's go to CSS file here and just copy this and paste it here down, and then here double colon after open bracket content, leave it like this, then width 100% and the height 2 pixel, background, sorry, background color will be this one, and then display block margin auto, and then Control S and refresh the page onto browser. You can see in the bottom side we have this hover line, hover affected line. So let's come back to CSS. So now what we have to do, we have to remove this line because we want this line when we hover on it. So this line should be appear when we take our mouse on it. So right now it's already appearing here, so we don't want right now. So for that, come to CSS file, and here width make it 0, Control S, you can see the line has been removed. So again, we want to, when we hover in it, we want again display these lines below these menus. So for that, come back to the CSS file and here copy this and paste it here, and then write hover and then after, and width will be 100% again when we hover on it, and make here transition here in the above here. So transition one s